daylight came, Saigon streets were empty. The city's under 24-hour curfew. Those helicopters sitting on top of the U.S. Embassy had come in to take out part of the Americans. Monitoring their radio frequency, we heard the report that they were taking small arms fire, and everybody was ordered off the roof. And just minutes later came the report from the embassy that all Americans are to be evacuated immediately.
The situation in South Vietnam and Cambodia has reached a critical phase. The options before us are few, and the time is very short.
I've seen mob cheating at these wars. This is outright panic.
The plane began to move as people still clambered up the ladder. Angry men left behind fired pistols and automatic weapons at the plane, determined that no one would go if they couldn't. A grenade went off under one wing, damaging it. Unable to move on the blockaded runway, the plane raced down the taxiway, swerving to avoid abandoned vehicles, perhaps even running over people. As the plane strained laboriously into the air, people were still clinging to the wheels and the rear stairs. Seven men fell off as the plane reached heights of 1,000 feet or more.
We all mobbed out of the bus, got into the contents of Shane's office, which was the staging ground for the helicopters that were going to come in. And as the first helicopters came in, Marines came rushing out of the end and started to lay down a defense perimeter. Almost immediately, the rocketing started to cease. And so we were all loaded aboard these helicopters.
His deputy in the Saigon embassy was telling businessmen around Saigon, invest. Saigon is as sound as the American dollar. So there was an air of complete unreality in that embassy. And what happened was we delayed planning for an evacuation to such an extent on the last day there wasn't even a list in the embassy, a master list of the Vietnamese who were in imminent jeopardy and who had to be evacuated.
And President Tu said his farewells emotionally and became an ex-president. One politician commented even before his 90-minute television marathon had finished, while he weeps tears of grief, what is left of our nation weeps tears of relief.
The fear was, that I felt, the VC had commandeered Air America Hueys and they were flying them around, which simply made a very interesting chess game.
It's a scene I'll never forget. We ended up going to the embassy. We couldn't get in the front there.
Then it started getting really unpleasant.
I wish you peace, and I have a great deal of faith that the future has to be ours.